Hey everyone, what's going on? Greg here again from Team Blast. I want to talk about how I use Local Falcon for all of my local SEO clients. This is really just a brain dump of what goes through my mind when I'm working on any client and what I'm looking to do to improve their ranking so they get more impressions, more website clicks, more phone calls, and hopefully more qualified leads each month. So here's one keyword, it's AC maintenance. So I'm tracking the results for one of my clients over here. And you have three metrics, ARP, ATRP, and SOLV. ARP stands for average rank position. It's out of 20. ATRP, you can be positioned 35. It's going to factor that in. And SLV is dots 1, 2, and 3. So what does that mean? So if you go down over here, this is the map. This is a 6-mile radius. I can see exactly how they rank in any quadrant within the six mile radius. So hypothetically, if you were near their location, you search for AC maintenance, you would find them. Or if you go maybe about a half a mile or a mile in any direction, you're still going to find them on page one. And you get to that 2 mile, 2.5, 3 miles, that's when they kind of start to fall off. But what's nice though is that I can see from a visual standpoint of where they started when they came to me, not really ranking at all for this keyword, but then I can see how the map is changing for them. That's really what local SEO is all about. Just trying to improve the map, get more qualified impressions, and hopefully get more leads too. So when I track their results, I throw all this into Excel to track the aggregate ranking. It's just much easier to see because sometimes when you share a report like this to a client, it's hard to see the progress because it's just slow. But if you look at it from where we started, it was back in February 8th, we had a 1.65% share of local voice. Now on the last scan that I did on March 25th, we have almost a 12% share. So we've improved basically by 10 percentage points of just going from a little bit under 2 to now just about 12%. You can also look at all the competitors too. I'm going to get into that in just a second. But what I also like to do too is I like to uncheck all the competitors because now it's a lot easier to see how the progress is going for my client. So when I do their month report or when I check in with them throughout the month, it's a lot easier just to share how they are doing. Otherwise, you have a lot of lines, it gets kind of messy. Anyway, now that I can see that the share of local voice is improving, that's going to lead to more phone calls and customers for them, I go into the competitor report. So the competitor report is where I spend a lot of my time. Clients will always ask me, what does competitor research look like from a local SEO standpoint? And this is really what it is. So I'm going to click on any of the listings over here and say, okay, K&S Heating and Air, they have almost a 30% share of local voice within the 6-mile radius. And we're all competing for really like the same clientele. So they're doing a great job. Then you have AC Pros at 27%, Cheryl Air Conditioning, et cetera. Every location I click on the map is going to change. That's what I like to do next. Click on the Compare Locations tab. I'm going to go to some random listing down here and just compare them against each other. When I do competitive research, I'm looking for gaps. So gaps for me are really simple things like, do they have a toll-free number versus a local area phone number? I've noticed that local area codes tend to perform a little bit better. It looks like a smaller business, especially for local clients. That's really important. You don't want to see them as like a big national brand. You want to be just a small local. We're in the community. We know the community. We have a local phone number. I always find that to be helpful. Next, I'll look at number of reviews. So we're talking about hundreds of reviews, very similar score, 4.6 versus 4.9. I look at categories and I say, okay, how many categories do they have versus what my client has, and say if we have too little or too much, I'm going to play around with that throughout the month and see what that does within the map. So I spent a lot of time looking at the compare section. Now let's look at the, so you can click on K&S Heating and Air, click on view on Google. So I have an initial standpoint, okay, they're open 24 hours. Obviously, that's a huge ranking factor. They have a physical address, that's a big ranking factor, et cetera, et cetera. Now, what I like to do over here is go into their actual Google My Business profile. And I like to click on their services tab over here. Now, this is helpful from a competitor standpoint because I don't know exactly what they're providing. Let's look for that term AC maintenance. You can see it right over here. AC system maintenance. It's actually their second one that pops up under air conditioning contractor. It must be very important. They even talk about it. I can click on view more and I can read how they talk about they do air conditioning solutions for residential and also for commercial. So they have a brief description that write about their actual service. That's helpful. That's probably also what's helping them rank a little bit better. Let's move back just a little bit, go back to overview. Next, I look at these service areas for all of my competitors and also my client too. Here's a tip. If you are struggling to rank better from a share of local voice perspective, you have up to 20 service areas that you can list off. Now, I recommend to play around with this. You can always change this at any time, but maybe initially you're too broad. You have, you know, your location is 20 miles out and you really can't compete outside of like, let's say an 8 to 10 mile radius. So you really want to, you know, bring those back in and say, okay, if I can just win better in an 8 to 10 mile radius, it's going to get more customers for me. the 20 mile service area is almost, it doesn't really make much of a difference because we're not getting seen for any non-brand keywords like AC maintenance or AC repairs. I need to tone that in. And now on the flip side, if you get too narrow and you get, say, I'm going to really focus on this 4 mile radius and I'm going to hit all the small towns and counties around me, maybe you restrict your growth. So play around with the service areas, see kind of what can help influence the map, play around with the service areas. Again, it's a ranking factor. And I've noticed that if you play around with it, you can kind of maybe flip one dot from 4, 5, or 6 to position 3. Next, I look at reviews. Now, reviews, in my opinion, are not the biggest thing when it comes to a Google My Business account. You can see they have 572. You can see their newest review came just a week ago. And before that was 9 months ago and 9 months ago, et cetera. Reviews are important, but think of reviews more from a people who view your business profile. They might want to click around to look at the actual reviews. That can actually help get a really qualified phone call because maybe they say, okay, perfect. This person does a lot of AC maintenance projects. I'm going to call them. But from a ranking standpoint, I'm not as convinced that who has more reviews or a slightly better rating is going to make that much of a difference. I think there's more factors at play. Next, look at updates. So I can see that they're not really that up to date when it comes to their updated section. Now, I recommend all my local SEO clients take photos of your team doing the work. There's a lot of debate over geotags when it comes to uploading photos. So I encourage a lot of my clients to upload their own photos, because maybe or maybe not, it plays a factor. But I think that if I'm in, let's say, New York and I'm updating the updates all the time for a company out in Washington, it may not hold as much weight compared to a company that's in Washington directly, let's say in Seattle, that uploads the photos. I feel like there's a little bit more of a weighted signal there. So if you can show photos of the team doing AC maintenance projects and you talk about it, you talk about the different towns or cities that you did the project in, I really think that that's a big ranking factor. Finally, photos too. Just really important just to have photos. I see this a lot of times where people will reach out to me and all they have is actually just stock photos, which is always kind of a little strange. I think, again, I look at it from a trust standpoint, also a clickability standpoint. You want to have authentic photos of the team doing the work. I always think it makes a big difference too. And then finally, look at their description. So I'm going to look for the word, let's see what they got here. Air condition. Yes, they got air condition over here. Air condition installations. So they have installations, they have repairs. Obviously, they're ranking pretty well for maintenance. These are all words that are kind of related to each other. So look for the gaps and say, okay, does my description, do I talk about the air conditioning projects that I do? Do my competitors do? How should I include different towns or cities in the description? Play around with all these settings. And then really finally, when you make all these changes, then you can track the results directly in Local Falcon. So all you have to do is click on either you refresh the report, if you're in the trend report section, you just click on rerun the scan. Because what's great is that then, let's say you make all these changes, you make description changes, updates, photos, you have some new reviews, you talk about your service areas, etc. If you then refresh the report, let's say in a few days later, and you notice now that you're ranking even better, it's kind of like, it's like proof of like, okay, got it. I did these small changes. I saw a little bit of an improvement. What if I got a little bit more aggressive? You know, what if I made more updates more often, or what if I got more reviews, or what if I did more question and answers about AC maintenance, et cetera? Like, can that help improve the rank? And if it does, then it might lead to more phone calls as well. But that's kind of how I look at everything for Local Falcon. There's so much more than just simply what I went over, but I want to kind of make this video short, but also just kind of explain a little bit about how my brain works with my local SEO clients, what I'm looking for. I'm looking for trends. I'm looking for improvements. I'm looking for more views, more, you know, phone calls, more website clicks, more leads, et cetera. And it all really starts within a tool that you can track all the progress in. Anyway, if you guys have any questions, feel free to reach out. I hope you found this video to be helpful. And as always, have a good rest of your day.